Next, we will discuss the Spaces tab. Up at the top, we will start at the Properties tab. This is a list of all of the spaces that you have in the project. As discussed in the previous video, these empty spaces will be filled in by information collected from the next level up. The Spaces tab is basically the lowest level there is. So if there's a particular space that has a particular load or construction type, and it's not the same as all of the rest of the spaces, then you would insert it here. If you go to the Airflow button, you can see Infiltration and Outdoor Air object names. These were edited in the previous video when we discussed space types on the Space Type tab. Again, all of this information will be populated from a higher level of information source. Let's go to the Loads tab. This shows all of the information that has been collected from higher level information sources. But if we had two different spaces that were exactly the same space type, for example, our storage rooms 105 and 106 are storage rooms, but if only one storage room had a microwave, we could simply drag and drop the microwave into that space. Go to the My Model tab, Equipment Definitions, Microwave, and you can drag and drop it to the space 105. And likewise, you would have to do the schedule for the microwave as well. But, so that differentiates this storage space from this storage space. But for this model, we won't be using that. So let's delete this. Next, we can go to the Surfaces tab at the top. The energy model is comprised of surfaces and subsurfaces. Surfaces are the main surfaces of the building: walls, roofs, and floors, and ceilings. Let's look at this. This is the apparatus bay. Let's say this apparatus bay had a different roof than all of the rest of the building. If we go to the Library tab and look for Constructions, we can apply a different roof type to this apparatus bay. You can see that it's now changed. And it's not green anymore. It's black because we have overridden this default value. If you want to return it to the default value, select the item and then push the X button up in the top right. You can see that it's now returned to the default value. You can do this for all of the surfaces. Likewise, you can do it for subsurfaces. Go to the Subsurfaces tab at the top. Subsurfaces are all of the windows, doors, and skylights, as well as interior windows and doors on the building. Subsurfaces are treated as children of surfaces. Here, we can double check the constructions of all of our subsurfaces. For the overhead doors, the construction type is empty. This means that we have not defined a construction assembly for overhead doors. Let's go back to the Constructions tab and take a look. If you look at exterior subsurface constructions, overhead doors is missing. We can choose to apply these overhead doors constructions from this value for the construction set, which governs the entire project, or we can apply that construction assembly just to the apparatus bay by going back to the Spaces tab and editing these subsurfaces. Go to Library, Constructions, and browse for a door type. Or alternatively, you could create your own. Drag and drop in place. Applying constructions at this subsurfaces level on the Spaces tab applies it to each individual component in the entire building. So for these overhead doors, we will apply these at this level. To copy to the other overhead doors, simply click the checkboxes, highlight the item, apply to selected. Let's look at the other assemblies. Glass doors. It looks like glass doors are also not defined. Let's go back to our Constructions tab. Glass doors. These are also not defined. To define the glass doors for the entire project, go to My Model tab and browse. We'll just browse for a typical window. Let's just use this one. This will apply to all the glass doors in the entire project, as long as this construction set is set as the default construction set on the Facility tab. which it is. Going to the Spaces tab again, we'll look at subsurfaces and scroll down, and you can see that those boxes have been filled up with the default glass doors. Some of the other buttons up here are for additional energy modeling. We will cover those in a later lesson. Selecting Interior Partitions tab at the top allows you to edit interior partitions. We don't have these in this model. Interior partitions are usually modeled as partial height walls, for example, like a cubicle. We don't have these in this project. The Shading tab at the top also, we don't have shading, but if we had individual shading objects, we could edit those individually on this tab. That's all for the Spaces tab. Thank you. Please like and subscribe.